everybody, Jackie from Cathcart Creations, and today we are here with my bestie Sarah. I came home to Indiana to visit my friends and family, and I didn't realize this until I came here, but apparently there's a Hobby Lobby in my hometown. So what today's activities are going to consist of is going into Hobby Lobby, browsing, having shenanigans, and also Sarah made me this awesome diamond painting for Christmas that I just received because apparently the mail sent it back, and well, sometimes that happens. But we are going to go ahead and go in, and Sarah, would you like to say anything?
Welcome to Jackie's channel. She's a very great artist, and I hope you enjoy our video.
Alrighty, let's go and have some fun, and to be safe, masks, because this is during the time of coronavirus, and we have to be safe. Be safe with masks, be safe with hand sanitizer. Want some hand sanitizer?
Sure. Oh my gosh, Daddy.
We'll share. This is what friends are for, right?
Sharing. Except when it comes to germs.
Right. Don't share your germs. Wash your hands and use hand sanitizer. We'll see you inside. Hobby Lobby!
Let's go in.
Where should we start?
Well, depends on what you're looking for.
I'm just here to browse, so if you have anything that you want to look for, I mean, we can literally go through the entire store and see what's up.
See what's up.
Yep. Those are really cute.
What is this?
Oh!
If you can read this, bring me a pumpkin spice latte.
Oh my gosh. Way to be dramatic, I suppose.
I have a glass that says looking sharp. That's a hedgehog.
Hedgehogs are so cute.
Oh my gosh, look at these stickers. I might have to grab some since I do happy planning.
Feed me and tell me I'm pretty. That kind of sounds like you.
That's definitely me.
Let's see what they got.
Care for some New Year's glasses? Only 99 cents, hey.
You make my heart happy. It's cute.
That's super cute.
Metal too. I think I'll keep this one. No one gets me like you. Aww. Oh,
that's super cute.
That's us.
Welcome, friends. Great things take time to grow.
Cool.
Let's see, are there any other different ones? Always choose joy.
I like that one. That's cute.
And then blessed beyond measure.
Aww.
How cute.
Eat cake for breakfast.
Yes. Always eat cake for breakfast. Y'all spoken here.
Also, these paintings behind you are really nice. I stink at doing landscapes and particularly architecture. I'm still growing and learning, so eventually I might learn it, but this was kind of what I wanted to show you because I was like, ooh, I need to turn the camera around and stuff, but you guys already heard that. This is probably getting edited out. Oh my gosh.
That's what I wish we were doing, but Rona.
Yeah. The coronavirus has ruined summer plans. But, oh well, it's fine.
Like,
we still get to go to Hobby Lobby, so that's nice.
Go home, Rona, you're drunk.
Ooh, inspired! Stay inspired, friends! And then a shout out to my sister Kayla. She loves pineapples and pandas. It's a weird combo, but she loves them.
Oh my
God. They have sunglasses! Oh my goodies.
If I could bake, I would bake.
Yeah, I can't bake either. Oh, I'm still recording. What the heck? Well, there's a blooper. This video is just gonna be full of randomness. Complete and utter randomness. How do you use washi tape this thinly, like for
planners?
Oh. I guess I don't use washi tape in planners as much as I.
This one is super cool. It's like watercolory and it's got gold accents on it.
No.
For $5, I might just get her.
Those pigments are really pretty.
They are. What was it you said about library and art? I mean, that could work, kind of.
Yeah.
It could be an artist library. That would be cool.
It would be cool. All right, here's where Sarah picks up a little bit.
Oh my goodness. Stickers!
Oh my gosh.
I have a llama.
Llama, 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 grandma.
Look at this. What is that? Are those cats?
Oh my goodness.
They're like
kitty sloth. And sloth mermaids.
That's.
You don't see that every day.
That's funny. I really am a mermaid.
Let's be mermaids.
That's funny.
If you were a mystical creature, what mystical creature would you want to be?
I don't know. Probably not a mermaid.
That was always my dream when I was a kid. Like a little kid. Whenever we'd be in the pool, I'd be like, let's play mermaids or dolphins.
I'm a bad swimmer, so. Oh my gosh.
Apparently, I loved swimming by the time I was 3 or 4.
So. Those bees are so cute.
Meow.
I probably wouldn't be a unicorn either. I don't know what I would be.
Hmm. Fairy?
Possibly.
I could see you being a pixie or a fairy or something.
I could do that, but I am not wearing that mini skirt.
There are fairies that wear pants or nothing at all. I mean. We are in the do-it-yourself paint by numbers aisle, and I saw these. There, this is The Starry Night by Vincent van Gogh, or Van Gogh, or Van Gogh, however you want to pronounce it. And then also, the sunflowers. That's so cool. I can probably try and do it by myself without a paint by numbers. I don't know if I want to do that quite yet. And then diamond art over there. Her mom got her this giant one that's like the size of a full-blown tapestry. It's huge. Crayola! What every artist starts with, right?
Yeah.
Yep. Sarah, are we having a blast?
We are having a blast. Who comes to an art Hobby Lobby and doesn't have a blast?
I don't know.
Obviously, people who don't like art.
Then why would they come to a Hobby Lobby?
Exactly.
Oh, my goodness.
This is like 9 projects in one.
Oh, my goodness.
That's interesting.
I use Royal and Lang Nickel a lot for paint. And stuff. Their acrylic paint's actually pretty decent.
Really?
And their watercolor too.
Neat, because they have the paint by numbers, and then they have engraving art, which I really want to learn how to do. And then they have
colored pencils. That's awesome.
How cool is that? Don't need any more projects right now. I bit off more than I can chew.
Watercolor pads. I got some little watercolors at Walmart. They're little travelers watercolor set. I might get one of these so I can do something with it later for the latter part of this video where I actually make something. And they're 4x6, also pre-cut. Paints. Oh, I could become Bob Ross, people. See? Haha. Ha ha ha. I got my artist shield. It's an. Getting the last one. Woo! It's Tico! I miss my baby. I miss my baby so much. Okay, hi everybody. So we just came back from Hobby Lobby. Actually, technically we went to dinner first and then we came back. This is Sarah's wonderful home that she's letting me film in and stuff. So we just wanted to show you guys what we got at Hobby Lobby. And also just a couple of things that I got at Walmart a couple of days ago that I will be using later on in this video. But we'll do the Hobby Lobby stuff first. So, Sarah, what did you get?
Okay, so I am big into planners and happy planning. So I mostly got just planner stuff. I got these really cute sparkly pumpkins.
Nice.
Because I'm getting in the group for fall. I got this one too. This one has a bunch of scarecrows and stuff like that. But I mainly got it for this little guy right here. These stickers were originally like $1.99 and I got them for like 40% off, so they weren't really that.
There were a lot of good sales at Hobby Lobby today.
Very much. And then I got just your basic adulting book. So it's just got planner stickers. There's some really cool ones in there. Like there's one sticker that says like, I didn't kill my plants today. If anybody doesn't have a green thumb, that one's a good one.
That's me too. I try, but it doesn't work.
And then obviously my budget is more planning budget, so I keep track of all the money I spend. Not that I want to. It makes me cry sometimes. But these are just all these stickers of budgeting. You can put your, you know, like, oh, this is how I spent, savings. There's all different kinds of stuff. So I like playing with a lot of stickers in my planner.
Yeah, her buying stuff for her planner made me realize that I need to get back on bullet journaling. It's been a while. Like, I haven't bullet journaled since May. This year's been crazy. Let's just keep it at that.
And I just started in July, so.
But Sarah was kind enough to gift me these this 3-pack of journals. Let's open it up and see what the ones are. Because the only one I could actually see before we bought this is the one on the front. So I don't know what the middle and the back ones look like. So be yourself, but be your best self. So there's that. And then you're in the right place. This one's cute. It's like a brick design. And happy notes inside. It's very, very small lettering, but it's very cute and minimalistic, and I could probably do something on the front with like acrylic paint. And it's got dotted lines in it. So not the dotted grid I usually like, but still nice. Oh, this one's the dotted grid though.
It looks like this one might be a little different.
And this one's just blank.
Interesting. So you have like 3 different types of...
Mm-hmm. I could technically make this probably a little sketchbook if I wanted to even.
And then on the, like in the back page, they kind of have this little live creatively.
Cute.
And that one.
And then kind of to go along with those things, I got these fashionista stickers. And I didn't realize it until after I bought them. But here's a little Tico in her purse. I don't know if you can see it, but it's so cute. I miss my Tico baby. And then I figured instead of doing stickers, I could cut these out and glue them into my journal or any of these journals. It was only 59 cents. It was actually cheaper to do it that way. And then for the diamond painting that she gave me as a late Christmas present, technically a vinyl frame, but I figured it's square and the diamond painting square, so there's that. I got some pretty washi tape. And then you make my heart happy. figured I can put that on, well, somewhere in my little outdoor studio at home. So, and now, last but certainly not least, what I will be doing something with later is I got these watercolor, this little watercolor pad. It's 4x6 and excellent for watercolor techniques, cold press surface, acid free paper, and it's 140 pound 300 GSM, which is really good quality paper. I can't really do the, there's a warble. And then I also got Master's Touch Fine Art Studio metallic watercolor cakes. Thought that would be something interesting to do with. And then at Walmart last week, I got these Royal Langnickel watercolor flip kit for traveling. Since I am here in Indiana, I don't actually have all my watercolors. I use watercolor tubes typically. So I figured I'd try it out with the pans, and got a whole palette at Walmart and more washi tape. They're very pretty colors. But yeah, that is the haul with Hobby Lobby. Thank you for being patient with us in the shenanigans that went down. We had a lot of fun, right?
We did. We had a lot of fun. Definitely do like a Hobby Lobby date with your best friends.
For sure. We'll pass you on to me doing art later.
Hello everybody, this is Jackie from the future, and when I say in the future, I mean this is a voiceover that I did after I actually created this project. So a couple things that I wanted to talk about in the last few minutes that I have with you guys. I wanted to talk a little bit about some techniques that I used, what my inspiration was, and also kind of finish up the video and tie it all in a nice little bow. So, techniques first. Something that I've learned from watching other YouTubers like Shada Campbell and some other YouTubers that use watercolors is that when using watercolors, it's best to mix the paints and the colors that you want to use before you start. So that way, if like you're using a wet on wet technique, like I did for the background, the water doesn't dry too much before you apply like what color it is that you want to do in the background, because otherwise you won't get the effect that you want. Also, I just mentioned it, wet on wet versus wet on dry. The difference is wet on wet creates a really nice gradient, whereas wet on dry is to make more precise details. And I used to at least start the sketch, the painting of the little butterflies, I started those with wet on dry, but then to add cute little details and stuff, I did the wet on wet technique. So you can see that there. So reason why I decided to do this fantasy girl or whatever, I actually found a really good reference on Instagram, not on Instagram, on Pinterest, and I'll put it up here on the screen so you can see it and also who the original photographer was. I saw it and I was like, this would be perfect to send to my grandma because she's currently in a nursing facility and I wanted to send her something to cheer her up. So I felt like this would be a very good piece to send to her since she also was an artist in her own way. She loved doing cross stitch and such, but I felt like this was a really peaceful and really nice piece to be able to send to her. And I just really enjoyed making the details work. And one of my other favorite parts of this was doing the hair, which I'm actually starting right now. I love painting hair because basically you just use the strokes that you're using to kind of show where the hair is grouping together, and it looks pretty natural and really nice. I also enjoyed doing her face. I kind of talked over that when I was talking about like what my inspiration was and what techniques I used, but it was a lot of fun and I love shading. I've mentioned this before, and also I enjoy doing her sleeve because it's a really pretty piece. But anyways, we're coming to the end of the video here. I just wanted to let you guys know that I appreciate all the support that I get from you, and I hope that if you like this video that you will like it and also subscribe to my channel and share this on social media so more people see things by Cathcart Creations. Also, check out the links in the description below to see more creations by me. And remember, stay inspired and create. Have a great day. Bye.